गेट 2019 इलेक्ट्रिकल क्वेश्चन 55। अ सिंगल फेज फुल्ली कंट्रोल्ड थायरिस्टर कन्वर्टर इज यूज्ड टू ऑब्टेन एन एवरेज वोल्टेज ऑफ 180 वोल्ट्स विद 10 एम्पियर कांस्टेंट करंट टू फीड अ डीसी लोड। इट इज फेड फ्रॉम अ सिंगल फेज एसी सप्लाई ऑफ 230 वोल्ट्स 50 हर्ट्ज। नेग्लेक्ट द सोर्स इम्पिडेंस। द पावर फैक्टर ऑफ द एसी मेन्स इज। रेफरेंस टू एनपीटीएल वीडियो पावर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स मॉड्यूल 4 सिंगल फेज कंट्रोल रेक्टिफायर्स पार्ट 2 by Professor G. Bhuvaneshwari, IIT Delhi. Useful data. Let us analyze the switching waveforms for single phase control rectifiers for a firing angle of alpha. So let us analyze the switching waveforms of the single phase control rectifiers one by one. So this is the axis. This is the V in supply, sinusoidal wave. This is the negation of the same input supply. The solid black line shows the output current waveform when the thyristors are fired at the firing angle equal to alpha degrees. Now in the next cycle, the thyristors, thyristor T2 and T3 are fired at an angle pi plus alpha. So again, the solid black line extends and shows the output voltage variation when the output current is constant and ripple free. IDC is shown by the solid green line is the constant rectified DC current. The displacement power factor. It is defined as the power factor due to the phase shift between the voltage and the current at the fundamental line frequency. Mathematically, it is cos of the distance in degrees from the zero crossing of the voltage and the current wave, that is cos of alpha. The distortion power factor. It is the measure of how much the harmonic distortion of the load current decreases the average power transferred to the load. So, as shown in the figure, the green dotted line shows the fundamental component of the square wave current that is shown by the green solid line. Mathematically, it is the ratio of the I fundamental upon I RMS. Thus, the total power factor of the converter is equal to the multiplication of the displacement power factor and the distortion power factor. For the single phase rectifier shown in the figure, the V output is given as 180 volts, V input is 230 volts RMS, I output is 10 amps, therefore, the source current waveform will look like this. Of 10 amps. Note that the RMS value of I source is 10 ampere only. And this is the firing angle alpha. As per power balance, P in is equal to P out, neglecting losses. Therefore, as real power is only transmitted, so V in RMS, I in RMS into power factor is equal to V naught, I naught, both are DC values. So V in RMS is equal to 230, I in RMS is equal to 10 amps, power factor is unknown, V naught DC is 180, I naught DC is 10. Therefore, 230 into 10 into power factor is equal to 180 into 10. If a power factor is equal to 180 upon 230, that is, alternative solution. As we know, the source current waveform is as follows. This is the input supply. This is the input source current square wave, which is displaced by angle alpha, and the dotted line shows the fundamental components of that square wave current. Here, the power factor of this input is distortion power factor into displacement power factor. So distortion power factor is I fundamental upon I RMS into displacement power factor, that is cos of alpha. I fundamental upon I RMS of the square wave is, so as we know, the fundamental component of the square wave is, that is, the RMS value is 4 by pi by root 2 into IDC upon IRMS is IDC into cos of alpha. That is 2 root 2 by pi cos of alpha. This is the power factor. Now, from where do we get the cos of alpha? As we know, the output voltage DC is equal to 180 volts and V naught of single phase control rectifier is given by 2 Vm by pi cos alpha. Therefore, 180 is 2 into Vm, that is 230 root 2 upon pi cos of alpha. Therefore, you can get cos of alpha given as 180 into pi upon 230 into 2 root 2 and substitute it back into the input power factor equation.